watching WDSU First Edition, your first live look at today's news and weather.
And welcome back to First Edition, wrapping up a fun weekend. Got to get back to the work week and the work week grind. We'll do it first by checking out the satellite radar imagery. Look across the nation right now, and you can see the middle portion of the country right across Oklahoma. We got some showers and some thunderstorms working there. Also approaching this side of the Mississippi River Valley, right around Indiana. Also parts of western Tennessee and western Kentucky. That's all associated with a cold front with the surface features in. There it is. Now, this area of high pressure is going to keep moving in this direction toward the southeast. That's going to force this cold front in our direction. Now, it is going to weaken as it gets through here, but I think it's going to provide just enough, a little bit of forcing to get that lower atmospheric stuff that's the surface lift and get us maybe a few showers and thunderstorms. And there, believe it or not, is our first tropical system of the season. That is Alberto starting and jumping ahead. Hurricane season doesn't start till June 1st, but as sometimes happens, we get these storms popping up. This really isn't going to do anything. As you can see, the very tight little storm right now is going to be diminishing as it continues slowly tracking toward the southeast. Then eventually it's going to move off toward the northeast as this cold front starts to push through here. No, not really anything to bother the United States with, but an interesting thing occurring early in the hurricane season. Yesterday's high was 88 degrees, average is 86, so staying just above that average. That will continue for today. We're going to forecast a high of about 89 degrees, and you know what? You'll be wishing for 89 by the time we get to Thursday and Friday because temperatures are going to be warming up. I'll show you that as well. 64 right now in Hammond, 69 around the New Orleans International Airport, 65 in Gulfport, and 77 and quite warm down in Grand Isle. Winds are calm except for one spot right around the Lakefront Airport with speeds there of 12 miles per hour. Fog, not looking at a whole lot at the moment, so we're going to move on, but Boothville, visibility there down to 5 miles, so maybe a little bit of fog. So your exact cast headlines are showing that we are going to work in a slight rain chance beginning this afternoon through tomorrow, and then temperatures are going to be pushing above the average by the time we get to Thursday. In humidity, while it's been on the lower end, it is going to return. And check out the forecast model. There's your isolated rain chance, mainly on the North Shore and along the Mississippi Gulf Coast. And then a shower chance overnight tonight. I think this overdoes it a little bit. I think it's a little quick. But I am going to throw in the chance for a few isolated showers, maybe a thunderstorm overnight tonight. And then tomorrow, as that cold front kind of lingers in the area, down toward the south, we'll see a few more scattered showers and storms by the time we get to Wednesday. Maybe a 20% chance of rain. And then Thursday is going to signal a big change as high pressure moves over and really starts warming everything up. So mid-80s, low 90s for today. Isolated showers and storms are possible. That isolated rain chance will continue in the overnight hours, mid-60s, lower 70s. And here's your 7-day exact cast. Here's what I'm talking about. We'll use rain chance tomorrow with that cold front passing 30%, 20% by Wednesday. And look at the 90s right across the board. If you live on the North Shore, say near Hammond, you could be right around the mid-90s with heat index value approaching triple digits. When we get closer to that, we'll talk more about it. But right now, this is your First Edition First Look at Weather. Randy, back to you.
Thanks.